So I gotta admit it, I'm very, very, very impressed with Restaurant to Another World. Now in terms of can I review every week, I don't know. I told you guys it'd take about 2 episodes for me to figure out if I'm going to be repeating myself every time. And nonetheless, what I found out from this episode was really, really unique. Like, I love how this, you know, this door, and they called it Willem's Door, which technically only one of them was Willem's Door, but they still call it Willem's Door since he is always there. But nonetheless, I thought it was really cool how this restaurant connects everyone. I thought it was really cool, like the whole sword, the story of the sword, and that guy not knowing that it's only, you know, it only appears once every 7 days. I thought that was really, really cool. I love how he returned to that finally, and how the guy that's as usual there knows that place very well, and how it returns, when it returns, and where. I love how he got in and back there, and I love how he met the chef once again. I thought that was really cool. Great job by, you know, Silver Link and the author. I thought that was really cool. So what that goes to show too at the same time, along with the treasure hunter, who is basically the main character of the story, in or episode I should say, but it shows that not everyone knows about this door. They don't know all the secrets. Like, this door is really mysterious actually, and not even the chef knows about it. So maybe the dragon's, you know, the only one that actually knows a lot about this door. But nonetheless, you know, the treasure hunter's saying, what is this? Not even familiar with this. And she didn't even know about it, even though her probably grandfather, I'd have to say. I mean, I don't know, or unless, you know, Willem was somebody she just looked up to. It's really cool to see that not even the treasure hunters know about this door, you know, a lot of them. So that was really cool, and now she's as usual there too, and I thought that was really unique. Now, if they're presenting a new character every episode, and, you know, a new founder, you know, per se, like someone who just now finds the door and finds the restaurant, someone new every individual episode, now that's something that I could review. I mean, because there's going to be same plot, but, you know, a different story. In a sense, right? I guess that's, same plot, different presentation, maybe even better than that, because each character's going to be different, so it's going to, you know, the restaurant and how they think the dialogue and stuff is always going to, you know, be perceived different from that new character. But it also shows, like, the culture difference in the show, and whenever I say the culture difference in the show, I mean that in the sense of we have characters that don't even know how, you know, what ice water is. Like, they don't even know what ice water is. And it's like, and so, you know, it goes to show from their time, where they're from, that's not even a thing. And then at the same time, the whole shrimp thing, yeah, you can't even get the shrimp to another town without it spoiling. That's what the guy from the medieval-esque time period stated. But yeah, he's like, holy crap, how did, you know, did he get this here without it spoiling in time? How did this guy do this? And, you know, we have cars, vehicles, all these things today that are literally 100 times faster than maybe putting shrimp in something and, you know, just taking away in like a carriage. We also have coolers, which they definitely didn't have coolers back then. So nonetheless, I thought that was really cool. But the sad part of the episode actually was finding out that Willem's dead. But at the same time, we did find out that the day of Saturn is the day that this door opens. Now, I did look at my anime list to see, you know, new characters, what are all characters going to be introduced, when I saw the treasure girl, I was like, what kind of role is she actually going to play? Is she a main character, support character? But I did find out that we have a black-haired girl that's actually going to be a support character. So I'm really just interested. I mean, the mystery of the door has me interested, and I think this may actually allow me to review the show, but I'm actually enjoying, you know, reviewing this said series, show, whatever you want to call it, right? Anime. And I hope it does have it, you know, each time has a new character and it presents them differently. It presents, you know, we get to perceive it differently. New dialogue, a new approach to how they found the door. I think that's something that could really make this show be really good, and I'm loving this. Silver Link is a, and, you know, for shows like this, I like whenever Silver Link does them. Usually they do like the harem-esque shows, maybe the romantic rom-coms, right? And some of them, I don't know if they've done a straight, have they done a straight romance? I know they had, you know, had to have, but I can't remember if I've seen one. But yeah, this is a little bit different for Silver Link. I think we all could agree with that. I don't remember Silver Link doing something quite like this show. You know what I mean? So nonetheless, it's the first time, you know, first crack at a show like this for me, at least from what my knowledge. So it's cool to see them actually excelling at it. But as always, guys, you guys have been Hex. Be sure to leave a like, come subscribe, follow me on Twitter, X25. See you guys next time. Peace. Thanks for watching, guys.